different cloud types, a very conventional topic of our syllabus. But because the new cloud atlas has been released, where 12 new names have been added to the cloud category, and that automatically makes an important reference point for our coming examination. So this is oriented towards making us understand the basics of the cloud classification and how these 12 names, actually we can count it as 11 also, I'll just explain that. Officially 12 new clouds have been added to the list. Conventionally, World Meteorological Organization have been demarcating cloud type on the basis of its genera. So 10 cloud types have always been taken into account, the conventional category. So if I just take the projector image for that, the conventional cloud categories that are 10 genera categories of clouds remains as it is. So it's not an absolute classification, we all are aware of it. But based on the altitude, we can demarcate the cloud type. So cumulonimbus clouds, lower level cloud, stratocumulus, nimbostratus, cumulus stratus remains as it is. Similarly, the mid-altitudinal clouds as altocumulus and altostratus remains as it is. And the high-altitudinal cloud already visible in this, cirrocumulus, cirrus and cirrostratus. So the 10 clouds as the conventional categories have not been changed. What has been added can be applied as, number one, the species category of cloud, number two, the supplementary features related cloud. Just to save on time, I have taken that writing part already on board, so we can take reference of that one by one. So what are the new categories that have been added? So new clouds can be categorized as species cloud, supplementary features related cloud, accessories cloud, and also special cloud. What we needed to understand is that special cloud is distinguished because it is having its development process as both natural plus human induced factors. That is the reason we call it special type of cloud. They can have their features that can be related to the conventional genera categories of the cloud, but they are different categories of cloud. Different in the sense that they are much more localized and can have human impact related to it. So when I say rest of the clouds, that is accessory clouds or supplementary features related cloud or species cloud, they actually correspond to the 10 fundamental genera of the cloud. So going with each one of them one by one. So the new species of the cloud that has been added is called volutus cloud. If I take this volutus cloud and take its definition as tube cloud, we can see that in the image. This tube cloud is largely related to the mid-altitudinal cloud. So mid-altitudinal clouds includes which cloud? Altocumulus, altostratus, and I can also relate it to, we can see that in the background work, this tube cloud can also be related to the stratocumulus cloud. So basically this species have been added to, it's a tube cloud that largely goes with the mid-altitudinal cloud, so both the alto category of cloud plus stratocumulus, the low altitudinal cloud. So it's a new species that have been added. What is the name of this? It is called volutus cloud. It's a tube cloud. It do have what its characteristics overlap with the supplementary cloud. We are going there one by one. Now the supplementary features related clouds are identified to have these categories. Which are these five categories that we are taking into account? It's Asperitas. Names are largely coming from Latin American terms, so they are sounding difficult, but once we take the images, it becomes easier. Asperitas clouds are wavy clouds. These clouds basically gives us the understanding of, it's a variant we can say of the globular clouds. Asperita clouds, the wave cloud, as if we are underwater, we are noticing the waves. So Asperita clouds gives us that very typical characteristics of wavy, and it largely relates to the bad weather conditions. It is correlated with bad weather clouds, so I can relate it to the cumulonimbus category of cloud and rain bearing clouds. So cumulus variant, so stratocumulus, cumulus can be added to it. So wavy clouds there. In the continuity of it, if I just change to this cloud, it will give you more understanding. This cloud is called fluctus cloud. Now you just have a comparison between fluctus, the supplementary feature cloud, and Asperita, the supplementary feature cloud, Esperita and Fluctus, both are wave clouds. But what makes them different? See Fluctus very carefully. Fluctus represents breaking wave. When the sea waves approaches near shoreline, it is the wave crest that fails to attain the circulatory support and creates breaker. Fluctus cloud is that breaking. It looks like a breaker cloud. What will facilitate its development? Slower wind velocity at the bottom, higher wind velocity at the top. Have a comparison. Fluctus cloud to Esperita cloud. Both of them are wave cloud, but they are different from each other. And as I said, this category represents category 2 as per our list. This category represents supplementary cloud. So basically, existing 10 genera of cloud will have these associated characteristics identified. So which are the clouds that can be applied as wave cloud? It's Esperita cloud and it is Fluctus cloud. Both are the clouds that are related to wavy characteristics but are different from each other. Supplementary features to the existing cloud, so we can relate to. Like I have said, cumulus cloud, I can easily relate Esperita cloud. Same I can do with the Fluctus cloud, when the wind velocity is marking up the difference. The other categories of the cloud one by one. Covum cloud, it's largely related to cirrus cloud. And if we take the conventional reminder for us, cirrus family has three members. One is cirrus, that is fibrous cloud. Two is a cirrostratus, that has got sheet characteristics. And three is a cirrocumulus, that has got certain globular characteristics to it. Non-reindeering, fair weather cloud. It's a sheet cloud that we can largely correlate, where supercooled droplets tends to generate this vacuum. If you try to understand its characteristics, in the overcasted sky, there is a patch where we don't see any cloud formation. So when we talk about the cloud type that is covum, covum is basically related to a vacuum that is created in largely the sheet cloud. And which type of cloud it will be? Sheet cloud means stratus family we are talking about. But in which type of cloud it is more likely to evolve? This supplementary feature or this supplementary feature related cloud, it will be cirrostratus. We are not ruling it out with cirrocumulus either, but it will be more related to cirrostratus. Reason, cirrostratus will be the thinnest of all the sheet clouds that we see in the genetic or genera category of the conventional classification of cloud types. Now comes in the cloud type that gives us an overlapping characteristics. What is that overlapping characteristics? You can see the tail. Cauda clouds are tail cloud. This tail cloud looks more or less like tube cloud. Now you need to understand that this tube cloud or this tail cloud, what is the reason they are different? Tube cloud called Volutus is actually a species of the cloud. So going back to that image to have a comparison, in the overall look we'll be having them to be similar. This is Volutus cloud, which is a different species of the cloud, which can be related to the mid-altitudinal clouds as we referred earlier. And when I say tube cloud, it's a supplementary feature. So a Volutus cloud can include Cauda. Cauda, the tube cloud, is commonly correlated with the water bodies. We don't have such over water bodies with strong wind in a particular direction. So it's something that is different from what we identify as a new species added to the cloud list. So Volutus is a tube cloud, whereas Cauda is a tail cloud. Number one difference. Number two difference, Volutus is a species of the cloud that can be related to mid-altitudinal cloud. And Cauda is a supplementary feature as specified conditions of its development. What we can specify, you can see this in image, it is largely over water bodies where there is a favorable supply of moisture and a specific wind direction in a particular point. So that gives the development of this tail cloud. Actually, we have got one more tail cloud that is called Flumen. So just skipping on the sequence, if I ask you to take that comparison, carefully notice the tail can be seen here also. The tail can be seen here also, but it's a beaver tail that we are applying. I hope it is evident. So when we talk about the supplementary features cloud, where we have tail cloud called Cauda And the accessory category of cloud, where we have got the cloud called Flumen. So Flumen encircling it, Corda encircling it, and Volutus cloud encircling it. They all are linear clouds. Difference between them, number one, Volutus cloud is a species, new species of the cloud. When I talk about Corda, it is supplementary feature of the existing cloud called tail cloud, and this tail cloud will be typically developing over water bodies with a consistent wind movement. And the accessory cloud, as has been applied by World Meteorological Organization, this accessory cloud is Flumen. Flumen is a beaver tail cloud. Beaver tail cloud, we have got something as V orientation to it. It can be corresponding to the base of cumulonimbus cloud. So Flumen as an accessory cloud can be related to bad weather cloud, cumulonimbus cloud. And this Flumen cloud can be identified with its association with Morus. Which type of cloud Morus is? Carefully see. It also has the base of cumulonimbus cloud. Only difference, it's a complete one. When we develop a cumulonimbus cloud, we create a near flat bottom. That near flat bottom with a globular mass at the top will create a wall-like cloud. That cloud is called Morus cloud. Morus cloud is wall cloud, and Flumen cloud is beaver tail cloud. They both can relate to cumulonimbus cloud, have got a different shape. Have a comparison of the tube and tail clouds now. Quickly changing over the images to reach there. I want to begin with the fluctus cloud. The tail, the tube cloud called Volutus, changing over to the tail cloud, that is the tail cloud, that is the Corda cloud, and beaver tail cloud right here. The beaver tail cloud, that is Flumen. So when we take the reference of Flumen cloud and try to relate it to Morus. Both Flumen and Morus, pinpointing your names for us. Both Morus and Flumen will be relating to cumulonimbus clouds. Both relates to cumulonimbus cloud base. However, Morus makes a clear wall-like cloud, and the accessory cloud called Flumen is a beaver tail cloud. Now the term tail gets overlapping with Corda, and it also gets overlapped with tube cloud. Are we having a clear association of cumulonimbus cloud with Corda? No. And is Volutus cloud, the tube cloud, also related to bad weather cloud as cumulonimbus? Can be, but predominantly it is related to the Volutus cloud predominantly is related to mid-altitudinal cloud. So they are different from each other. Let it be that in the overall shape they can have an overlapping view. So repeating it like this, Volutus cloud is a tube cloud, like it. Corda cloud is a tail cloud, like it. Flumen cloud is a beaver tail cloud. Beaver tail cloud is different from Corda cloud in spite of belonging to supplementary feature of cloud. Because when we talk about Flumen, the beaver tail cloud, I'm relating it to cumulonimbus cloud. Corda cloud is, however, that tail cloud which typically develops over a water body where the wind direction is consistent in a particular direction. And when we talk about Volutus cloud is a new species of the cloud identified in the classifications called tube cloud. It largely associates with, among the 10 genera cloud, it largely associates with mid-altitudinal cloud. So they are different from each other, they are not similar. Cohom, I have already told you, is related to cirrus cloud, I have already written it here. So which cloud I am relating Volutus cloud to be? Altocumulus, altostratus. Which cloud we have taken? Hesperica and the breaking wave. Fluctus clouds, they can be related to all the cloud types, largely with cumulus characteristics. So I'm just writing cumulus here. Breaking wave, cumulus. Breaking wave, the fluctus cloud will be distinguished from Hesperita clouds, because Hesperita clouds are simply waves, But fluctus cloud is having the breaking wave characteristics. Fluctus cloud will have breaking wave characteristics because it has got stronger wind velocity at the top and slower wind velocity at the bottom. And compared to it, if we see the cloud that is Esperita, it's actually the wavy clouds that we are noticing. So we can relate it to the cumulus cloud. Okay, coming to the list further, we have got Kovum, we have already seen it. Let me go to the image quickly. The Kovum cloud largely goes with the cirrus clouds. Cirrus clouds, which type of cirrus clouds? A cirrostratus cloud. Corda, the tail cloud, can be related to any of the cloud varieties. So not writing the name, the important thing that goes with it is water body. Breaking wave, I've already talked about. Murus cloud goes with cumulonimbus cloud, and so goes the beaver tail cloud. The wall cloud is Murus cloud. Murus cloud goes with the base of cumulonimbus cloud, and so is the characteristics of beaver tail cloud, that is a cessary cloud called fluent cloud. Now we have got this special category cloud, and if we try to insist on their name, the name are self-explaining. Before I go to images, carefully see it here. The special clouds includes five categories. Four of the names are written in front of us. The four are called Genetes clouds. So special clouds are 4 plus 1. So one is not written here. Special clouds are called Genetes clouds. How many Genetes clouds are there? 4. Cataracta genitus, Homo genitus, Selva genitus, Flamma genitus. If I try to apply the name, Cataracta genitus, cataract, continuous cascading pours of water, falling of water from variable height. It's largely related to waterfall. Homogenitus has to be correlated with human activities. So which type of human activities? I can apply it to the aeroplane movement, aeroplane fuel, the entire sequence of the movement of aeroplane with the emission, exhaust that it creates, can create homogenitus type of cloud. Silva very clearly relates to vegetation. In vegetative area, we have got evapotranspiration from the upper level canopy that tends to create cloud type, which is very typical to the forested area. I'm just coming to the images. And flamma. Flamma will either be with volcanic ejection or can be with forest fire. Now, forest fire is debated. Forest fire will be related to human as well as natural category. So one by one getting there. Which type of cloud this special cloud in the genitus category is? It is Cataracta genitus. You can see waterfall in the background. This is Cataracta, where the falling force of water tends to generate the localized cloud type. Any waterfall, if we talk about Chitrakoot in our country or we take Niagara Falls, of course not in winters, can easily give us this cloud. Which type of cloud this is? This is the last name that we have written. It's the Flamma cloud. Flamma cloud that can be related to the forest fire, can be related to volcanic ejection. Carefully see, it looks like a cumulonimbus cloud, but it's a different cloud type. It's not because of updraft. When we talk about the conventional genetic clouds of the cloud varieties. Which type of cloud this is? This is the airplane exhaust cloud. It can exactly be related to the homogenitus cloud, which is related to the exhaust of the airplane, as the example seen here. And which type of cloud this is? Yes, this is the cloud that can be related to selva genitus. Basically, these clouds are special clouds, special because under special conditions they mark their development. The only thing that I want to take before concluding is that homogenitus cloud includes a variant which is called homomimatous cloud. Basically, homomimatous cloud is the cloud that can mark its development both by human activities and natural causes. It again incorporates the cloud type, where we see a very defined kind of cloud formation at the bottom and near stable characteristics at the top. So basically, it relates to strong upper winds that is creating such cloud. So such clouds are identified to be involving human component to it. So we can include it in the homogenitus cloud. However, it correlates with something that can be natural also into account. So when it comes to homo mutatus cloud is identified to be mutatus. Homo mutatus cloud is thus identified with the possibilities of both natural strong upper wind that is restricting formation of cloud, it is carrying away the clouds, and we have got the cloud globular masses at the bottom, which can be somewhere related here. You can see this upper sky completely clear and we have got the cloud like this. So the appearance comes out to be more or less similar. Which are the 12 cloud types that we see in the new cloud atlas plus those 10 that was already there? So in total we have got now 22 clouds with us. So 12 clouds are categorized into 4 different categories: species cloud, supplementary feature cloud, accessories cloud, and special cloud. Special clouds are localized, can be a defined definition for it, but we need to understand that most of the other clouds also have got the specifications related to them. And if we try to remind us of the shapes of each of the clouds one by one, simply try to see the list and apply. Cloud number one, the tube cloud, that is Voltus cloud. Cloud number two, that is wavy cloud, we call it Espirita cloud. Cloud number three, the vacuum cloud, vacuum, ovum cloud, which is in the list of supplementary feature. Cloud number four is Cauda cloud. Cauda cloud is different from tube cloud, it's a tail cloud altogether, largely typical over water bodies as we have already understood. The next cloud in our list as per image, we can recognize it from the image as well as the list, it's a fluctus cloud, distinguished from Espirita clouds in spite of the fact that both the clouds, number one, are in the supplementary feature and number two relates to the wavy characteristics, is that it gives us a look of breaking waves. So fluctus cloud. The next cloud in our list is wall cloud. Wall cloud is predominantly related to cumulonimbus cloud. Murus cloud they are called. This completes the list of supplementary feature. As I take the accessory clouds, comes in beaver tail cloud, that is called flumen cloud. Flumen cloud is a variant identified, can be learned as this. It's a variant of Murus. Murus is a flat base and beaver tail makes it the flumen cloud. And beyond that, the special type of clouds that can have human influence related to it, common term applied to them is genitus cloud. So which are the genitus clouds one by one? It becomes easy once we see image. This is Cataracta genitus. This is Flamma genitus. This is Homo genitus. And I can relate it to Homo mutatus. And this is Silva genitus. Silva genitus, that is with evapotranspiration with the upper canopy of vegetation. There is the attached write-up to it. Just take the reference of it in context of this discussion. It will be very easy. There can be a possibility of the question from it because it is something that I'll not say is very new, but it is the thing that has to be taken in our stride in the understanding of cloud variants in the global recognition in the present perspective. All the very best.